Hello, King Kay, to get it spoken.
Hi.
And today we are talking about the mid-chapter patch. It has a lot of things added to it. And, oh, not a lot. What do you call a lot with behavior, eh? It is like a lot, I would say, would be multiple fixes, multiple balance fixes and such, but in this case it is not. It is not a lot. I would say it is a hand, it is a small hand, right, Falcon?
Yeah, but don't forget, this is going to be the second buff for the Trickster.
For the Trickster, yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah. So, think about it.
He needed it, eh?
Yeah, I still remember the PTB Trickster.
He sucks.
So, yeah, so imagine, we are after more or less 3 or 4 months, we are getting the second buff. So think how garbage this killer was at the release.
Yeah, not even all the other killers were fixed yet.
Yeah, and they we immediately complained about the weakness of this killer.
Yeah.
But you know, behavior has needs time to collect data from statistics.
Yeah, well, let's be honest, this Alma will need time to collect it, because we all know that he's a highly trained monkey in terms of statistics and such.
Yeah, and they released a killer which had no map control, had no slowdown, no one shot ability, and his anti-looping power was garbage.
It's not only that, but he was released too early, and it was it's almost fault, because let's be honest, it's almost fault, because he told the guy that was making the Trickster's power, who was balancing the Trickster, like, oh, you did a good job, we're gonna release it, even though he was not good, but he was like, yeah, he worked 6 months on the Trickster, I can't say to him that killer suck. Because that is the truth. That he said it on his own stream, you know that?
Oh, yeah, I remember.
He said it on his own stream, and then you know for a fact that is stupid, because you should never release a killer. If you know, even though he's a friend of yours, you should always say that the character is not good. That he has to work better on it, because it is not good. You know? You need to have a bit of competition in the company, and they don't have that. But let's go into the patch notes and read what they done, okay?
Let's go.
Let's see, the power maximum laceration is now 6 or 8. 2 less than normal, okay, that is good, I think.
Yeah, this also means 12 blades to down a survival.
Yeah. This is good.
Yeah, good, and I think this is the best change they made. Yeah, because I don't know if you saw that all Trickster players were using the add-on which reduced the maximum laceration to 7.
Remember? Yeah.
The Melodious Murder. Yeah, which decreased the laceration meter by 1.
Okay, that is.
Yeah.
That
so is basically, they understood that they needed to lower this maximum laceration meter.
Yeah, that is a good change.
Yeah, good.
Makes him less M1 dependent. Now he can combine M1 with his M2. That's good. Faster laceration decay. Full meter depletes in 15 seconds, 20 seconds of running. Okay.
This is a nerf,
Oh.
and because if the survivor manages to break the line of sight, he will be able to let the laceration decay faster.
I see.
Yeah, and in combo with the next change also.
Okay, and that is
Go.
Before lesser ranger starts to decay. Now 10 seconds plus 20 seconds, okay.
Yeah, so these two changes in combo, it means that your power is now high risk and high reward.
Oh, yeah.
And also, you must. I think that this requires some skill from the player in this way, because now you must be sure that you can down the survivor with the blades you have available.
Yeah, that's true, because
Because if you don't have enough blades available, so you need to recharge the lockers, basically you lose all the pressure you put, all the work you did is useless.
I see, yeah, that is makes sense.
Yeah. So be careful when you are low on blades and you are about to start a new chase.
So Iron Maiden will become a must-have perks for the tricks that to reload quickly.
Yeah, just like Huntress.
Okay, that makes sense. Let's see. Laceration removed upon successful basic attack now was four, is now three. Okay, that is when you try to hit him normally.
Yeah. Because this is just like Ghostface, for example. Remember, if you hit somebody with M1 as Ghostface, you lose all the stalk meter the survivor had.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, so this is similar.
Okay, I can understand it. Main event starts throwing knives 1 second sooner.
Yeah, and to be honest, I tried this change and it's insane. Basically, you tap the main event key and mm-hmm. you immediately start throwing blades.
Damn, that is...
Yeah, just... bro, it's a crazy camping tool.
I think a lot of campy killers will be happy with it.
Yeah, and if you are lucky enough, for example, you are in the basement.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tixer will be worse than Leatherface.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Basically, the survivor will not be able to escape you.
Damn. A lot of survivors are going to complain. First, they are complaining about poor Bubba doing his basement job. And now, now you got the trickster. Oh man, that is. That's going to be funny. Let's see, the next one is. 30 knife hits required to activate main event was 20. Okay, that seems like a fair trade then.
Yeah, this seems a nerf, but you know, they wanted to make the main event a more special ability. So, in this way, you will able to activate the main event less frequently, but it will be better because it starts sooner, and also you have now, see the next change, you have a longer window.
Oh yeah, that was one of our main complaints, that the window for it was so small.
I tried it and okay, 30 seconds is very long. So you can now you can decide when you need the main event to start.
That is good. I
Yeah,
like this.
this is very good.
Yeah, that is one of those fixes that was needed. Because I remember this, it was over so fast, you barely noticed that it was all active. So that is a good thing. And now, new knife hit indicator has been added to show when knives connect with survivors, okay. I don't know if it is anything special, but okay. I find it more important anyway. This is good. This is good. Now they just have to make trick blade base kit. Don't you think?
Yeah. The best changes in my opinion are the first one and the longer window for activating main event.
Yeah, that's what I indicate.
I really like these two changes.
Same.
Yeah.
The only, but like I said, the only thing that now that they just have to do is make the trick blade base kit.
That would be interesting, but you know, I don't. It's. I don't think behavior will do such a thing.
Yeah, but I think that would have been because he's called the trickster and he doesn't do any tricks. You know?
Yeah. You know, I agree with you because I also think that change will make the trickster more unique. The trickster is very similar to the huntress.
Yeah.
Very, very similar. So maybe what you suggest would make it a more unique.
Well, it would give him a deeper gameplay level because it will also allow you to try and learn how to use him in the environment, how to get the ricochets with the knives going, you know? I mean, the game style like that he has now fits better than Huntress. Huntress is more direct. She's a hunter. She is there to throw the hatchet and she's there to kill you. With the trickster, I think he's more of a showman. He wants to be showy, you know? So I think that giving him the trick blade as a base kit will give him a deeper gameplay mechanic. Like, oh, I'm gonna try hit that wall, and hopefully the survivor will get hit by the knife. You know? Those kinds of things. And I think that would add more gameplay aspect to the trickster. But that's just me. But I think they are scared that the knives are, that people are going to use the knives to ricochet off the ground towards the survivors or something, I don't know. But still, I think Trickblade should be base kit and it should add a little bit more of depth into the Trickster's gameplay.
Yeah, maybe they could put them with a reduced damage, for example. You know, there are a lot of ideas, you know.
Yeah. I know, but that's the best what I can go up with. Let's look at the add-ons and see what else they did. Not a lot of changes to the add-ons, don't you think?
Yeah, obviously they added to rework the Melodious Murder, of course.
Yeah.
Otherwise, the new trickster would have been overpowered.
Moderately decreased knives reload time at lockers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because, yeah, because believe it or not, all the trickster lacked a faster reload add-on.
True, that is why Iron Maiden was used, if I'm correct.
Yeah.
So, Fizz Spin Soda. Smaller effect. Starts at 2 nice tone instead of 3. Balance with smaller maximum laceration.
Yeah, this nerf was necessary, otherwise it would be overpowered with the new change to the laceration meter.
That's true.
Because basically you would get a 50% damage instantly. Yeah, so a bit too much.
Way too much even. Iridescent photo card. When a survivor's laceration is 2 or less blades hits away from the maximum, they are afflicted with exposed status effect. Okay.
Yeah, and this is more stronger than you would think, because consider that the maximum is 6. So basically now, if you throw 4 blades out of 6, the survivor will be exposed.
Yeah, and then you can just basic hit him or her.
Yeah, so don't underestimate this.
I don't.
This add-on.
I don't. Let's see. Death throws completion. When main event ends, the trickster's knives are replenished. Okay, makes sense.
Yeah, this is very nice. You can avoid reloading at a locker, basically.
Ooh.
Yeah. I tried it and it is very useful.
It's very nice.
Yeah. Very, very nice.
Let's see. Lucky Blade. Hitting a survivor with a blade during main event slightly extends its duration. Okay.
Yeah, you know, the idea is good, but I'm not, you know, 0.2 seconds is very, very, very short. So I'm not sure if this add-on is worth it, to be honest.
Same, it is. To be honest, the other one is also not worth it, this one waiting for you.
You know, I don't know if this... Because reading the description, I don't understand if it is stackable.
Same.
Because if you hit a survivor with one blade, you extend the main event by 0.2. But what happens if I hit with two blades? Do I get 0.4 seconds? Extension?
I don't know.
Yeah, we will try to. We need to experiment, maybe.
Yeah, but to be honest, this is my point of view. I don't see a point of stacking these two. You know, when I can have something like this, or this, or even this. I mean, these other ones are way better than these two. You know? Oh, these other... except Spin Soda, but that's because...
Yeah, you know, bro, not every add-on should be useful.
Yeah,
according to OBL. So it's okay to have... I don't want to say garbage, but let's say weak add-ons.
Yeah. Let's just say the small fish and arms. Okay, perks. Now, this is going to be interesting. No Way Out. After hooking a survivor for the first time, No Way Out gains a token. Once the exit gates have been powered. No way out activates. Aha, that means that it will now activate after the survivors touch the exit gates.
Yeah, and to be honest, this was the only change this perk needed. Because, I experimented a bit with No Way Out, and this was exactly the problem. Because the perk blocked the exit gate switch just after the completion of last generator. So the result was that you were losing the time it took for the survivor to get from the generator to the exit gate.
Aha.
Yeah, and considering that the duration of the perk was not so long, basically you lose 50% of the effect of the all the No Way Out.
Yeah, I now, know that.
Now it would be, I think, better than Remember Me, maybe.
Mm-hmm. So I would still combine the two. Sorry, people. I'm something went down the wrong throat hole.
So now you are guaranteed that if you call survivors, you will be able to block exit gates for 1 minute, basically.
Yeah, that is good.
Yeah.
Okay, when a survivor interacts with an exit gate switch, you receive a loud noise notification. The entity then blocks both gate switches for 12 seconds, plus an additional 12 seconds for each token in your position. Okay. To be honest, you know, this is just me, Falcon, what I'm gonna say, Because I don't know what you think, but this is not very good still. They need to change this, you know?
Bro, this means 1 minute. In which the survivor can't open the exit gate after they reached the switch.
Yeah, but I mean, the problem is, what I got with it, you know, is that they are blocking both exit switches, you know? Instead of just blocking the one that is being used, you know? So if a survivor is going for, like, the exit gate that is close to the killer, for example, and it touches it there, then it will be blocked, while they already had opened the exit gate on the other side. Understand what I mean?
I don't know. Maybe it's a bit situational. I don't know.
It's just maybe I'm overthinking. It can also be, you know. I mean, if let's say one exit gate is completely on the other side of the map, for example, you know, and the other one is close to the killer, where he is camping the survivor, for example, because that is possible, that the end game starts and that is the only survivor that the killer could grab, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Would it not be better, for example, if they touch the gate at the other side of the map? They try the 99 net and it gets blocked, you know?
Yeah.
And then they are 99-ing it, and then they are sneaking past the killer, and they try to open the gate by the killer side, and then all of a sudden it gets blocked then by the on that side. So that survivors are in the open, they are and the killer can still go there because they cannot open the gate there for so many seconds. Maybe I'm overthinking it, maybe I'm making it too complicated, but still, it's better than it is right now, so.
Yeah, for sure. This one is much better.
Maybe I'm just overthinking it. It's possible because, certain.
Maybe, bro. I would like maybe a perk for regressing the exit gate progress, maybe.
Yeah, but that one will
Yeah,
never come.
I think maybe they should rework Remember Me for working like that.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, because this strategy of putting the exit gate at 99, it's just dumb because it allows survivors to avoid the endgame collapse entirely.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, I understand behavior doesn't want to put it in the base kit. Okay, but at least give me a perk for that.
Yeah, it is. To be honest, behavior is too scared that they lose survivors so that they can't get the money for it, I mean. One of these days, behave, you need to stop giving survivor training wheels and start being a bit more, But I think for that to happen, there has to be different management and behavior for it to influence what is going on. So the next one is Hex Crowd Control Role. That is the totem bamboozle.
These blocks vaults automatically without you having to make the to first make the vault by yourself, and this perk automatically blocks the window when the survivor vault for the first time. But to be honest, even with this buff, I still prefer Bamboozle, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah, because the problem is this perk is a hex perk.
Yep.
That is the problem.
It's not only that,
Yeah.
but Bamboozle gives you more
Because,
chase ability.
yeah. Yeah, but also the survivors can't destroy your perk. That is
Correct.
the problem. This crowd control is a hex perk. They can easily destroy your totem.
True.
Yeah, but they can't remove Bamboozle.
Yeah, that is also true. So,
To be honest, bro, do you want to know how I would rework this perk?
tell me, bro, tell me.
I just give you the idea. Maybe it's overpowered, maybe not, I don't know. But we want a hex perk, a powerful hex perk for blocking windows. Okay, so remove this duration and make the perk block every window that the survivors vault till all the walls in the map are blocked.
To be honest,
Yeah. That way, there would be a reason to destroy this totem.
yeah, that's true. That is true because then the survivors will be like, "Oh, we have to destroy this totem or else."
The first survivor, maybe they vault in one jungle gym or two jungle gym. Okay, you block both jungle gym for the rest of the match.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be scary for the survivors.
Yeah,
And a
because
good reason for looking for the totem.
true. I agree. I totally agree with you.
Yeah, but this is just an idea.
I agree. They need to make this totem a bit more dangerous.
Because it is a hex, it should be powerful.
Yeah. So the next one that we are going to discuss is This one. These two. Effects that improve a killer's hearing, such as the perk Strider or the add-on Swing Chains, will only be heard from the killer perspective. Survivors will no longer hear themselves as louder when the killer is running such effect. That's good. Because this will make it so that...
Basically, this is a buff since there is no mean for survivors to understand that you have Strider or similar add-ons.
Yeah, because these are add-ons that should be in there should be a surprise. It should be a guessing game at this point.
Yeah. Because now, for example, if you have Iron Will, and for example, you are playing against the spirit, and you can hear your sounds of pain.
Yeah.
it's easy. You know that the killer is a Strider.
Yeah, and that is bad, because part of the game is guessing what perks the killer has so that you can play around it. And having it on an open platter in front of you is not a good thing. I mean, if you are healing inside the killer's terror radius and he's over something coming for you, you know that he has a nurse calling. You know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then you're like, okay, he has nurse calling. Next time I'm going to stop healing when I hear his terror radius. Or I'm going to heal really far away. That would be those kind of things. So this is good. Next one is effects that modify sound are now multiplicative. Okay. Rather than additive. Okay. This means that sounds that are reduced to zero, such as injured noises by the perk Iron Will, will no longer be increased by perks such as Strider. And will instead remain at zero. Okay, so...
Yeah, basically an indirect nerf to the spirit.
Yeah, because the spirit is the only killer in the game that uses Strider.
Yeah, and believe me, bro, I have been playing for about 4 years now, and believe me, I have never seen Strider used on all killers except spirits.
To be honest, I find that a really good thing that it is only used on one type of killer.
Yeah, or maybe another example. The only other example is Adept Nurse.
Yeah, but that is
To be honest, this is the story.
Yeah, but I couldn't be honest with you. You know, I'm happy actually that it is only used on spirit. You know. Because in a way it tones her down, because for all we know she could add another powerful perk in the place of Strider. Now she has a reason to add another strong perk to her arsenal. So it will be even more dangerous to face a spirit, you know? If you understand what I mean.
Yeah.
I mean, think about it. Now she doesn't have Strider. What other perk will she use? That's the thing. Now she has a spot open for like save the best for last,
for example, or the other good perk. In my opinion, would be Predator, for example, but I don't know.
Yeah, or sloppy boots.
To be honest, I don't know, bro. I think we need to wait and see what spirit players will do.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, nerving strider can be good because
To be honest, bro, it is it's simply I think they will play even more the meta.
Yeah, because
because now when you are playing Spirit, basically you trade one perk slot for Strider.
Yep.
Yeah. And now that Strider will be useless, I bet that Spirits will change and use another meta perk.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I see it like this. The Spirit will have like three strong perks and then Strider.
Yeah, exactly.
And now with Strider gone, they will add another really strong perk. So the Spirit will basically become a bit stronger. Yes, it loses a tracking tool, but it doesn't matter. She gets a little bit more power in something else. It is basically you trade in a lesser evil for a bigger evil, you know?
Yeah, and maybe I would only add one last thing. You know, since this is not the only nerf for Strider, because as you can see, it is also a nerf for add-ons which increase or modify the sounds.
Yep.
So yeah. So think about, for example, yeah, they talked about the swing chains. Because remember, Forever Freddy was nerfed.
Yep.
So basically, they turned strong add-ons into, I don't want to say useless, but little useful add-ons. Now, as a second part, they made a little useful add-on into a useless add-on.
Yeah, and it made a little useless.
So bro, I have a lot of swing chains in my Freddy, because they were the one of the best for when you played Forever Freddy. Now, I think I will forget forever the swing chains and also the jump rope and so on.
Yeah, they will
get no uses at all, because bro, we saw by our statistics, Iron Will is one of the most used perk by Red Rank Survivors.
Yep, and mostly only because it counters the Spirit.
Yeah.
And it's and to be honest, you know, it's kind of dumb of behavior. I mean, yeah, I can understand the Spirit is a problem for them to handle, but come on, it is like, you get Iron, the Survivors are using Iron Will, and they have Lucky Break now. I don't see the point in nerfing Strider, just because there is Lucky Break, and they have Lucky Break. Just add Lucky Break to your build, and you're done. You know? The Survivors are already using, like, Dead Heart. And now this. Behave, you really need to stop holding the Survivors' hands. Stop giving them training wheels.
Yeah, bro, so all in all, we can put a new perk, Strider, in the list of garbage perks.
Yeah.
Good job, Behavior. Good job.
Good job. The only killer that can make use of that one perk, and you had to butcher it.
Yeah. And also, this is, bro, you you found a good point, because this is a bad design, to be honest.
Yeah.
If because if you have one, if a perk is good only on one killer, it's a bad design, in my opinion.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
I mean, look at Legion, old Legion. He was the only killer that was actually good with Hex the Third Seal and with Remember Me. You know?
Yeah, you could farm tokens very, very easily.
Yeah, he was the only killer that had synergy with those perks. And they removed that. It's like, for me, you know, it's like, why remove synergy like that? You know? You're removing synergy for no reason, but hey, what do I know? Right? What do I know? I mean, I find it good that that certain killers have more synergy with certain perks than others. I mean, Oni has Infectious Fright. Let's see.
Bro, I get it, but Infectious Fright is good in general.
Yeah, but I
Yeah,
mean.
it's you know, bro, it's okay that. Maybe you have one or two killers that benefit the most from one perk. I understand it and I agree. But if you have a perk which is good only on one killer, and we have now 24 killers, remember? Yeah, that is bad design.
That's true. That's true. That is true, but still. I mean, if it is only on one killer a certain perk, then that means you only have to work. If it is only one perk, you know, in this case, Strider are only on the spirit, you know. It's basically a nerf, because the spirit could have used that perk stat that he is using for Strider for a perk that is already a bit stronger than Strider. You know, but it balances itself out. It's and that is the same if you are playing Slugmaster Myers with Infectious Fright or only with Infectious Fright, because those two have the best synergy with that perk. And it's like, you know, it's like, it would, I don't know how to say it, I can't get out of my words. It's just weird that they are trying to remove synergy between certain perks and certain killers. I mean, it would balance itself out more, you know, if one killer is better off with this one perk, you know. It's okay if it doesn't work for every other killer, but yeah, it's like you said, it is also a bad design. I mean, if Strider only works really well, if the Strider works like really well in spirit, then it should work like half as good on other killers, just to balance it out. But this is just an unnecessary nerf to a weak perk in the end. That is all I'm gonna say. Why make a weak perk even weaker? Just to nerf one character. Maybe fix the sounds in the game.
Oh yeah, because I want to remember that the no slug sound is still in the game.
Yeah, I used to be able to hear survivors walking above me in the game, or they are as such, and that is something also that you don't get anymore. Or you could even hear the footsteps of your killer, and that is also gone. It is like really weird without these sound issues. So I think they really need to fix sounds. You know? I think that is something that they have to fix, instead of something like a perk that is being used on a killer that a lot of survivors don't want to learn how to play against, instead of going for the cookie cutter, just press W to avoid, or loop, 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 you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh well, it is what it is, and up to the last one. Okay, I have only one thing to say about this one, you know?
Go.
Updated facial models. You know, updated facial models for the survivors. Quentin finally has a new face. About fucking time. Quentin is not ugly anymore.
Finally.
Yep. Don't give a fuck about anything else, Quentin. He's not ugly anymore.
Yeah. He has a new face now.
Yeah. There's a big gameplay improvement for him. Big gameplay improvement. Really. So. That is all. Last but not least. Keys with zero charges no longer can open the hatch. Wonderful.
Yeah, wonderful, because I think this is for compensating the nerf to Franklin's demise.
Yeah, but they also had a lot of backlash for it, eh?
Yeah, and also, to be honest, this was a singular anomaly, to be honest, because I'm pretty sure that keys were the only item which could be used with zero charges.
Correct.
Yeah, because remember, medikits with zero charges, you can't use them anymore. Toolboxes with zero charges can't be used to repair generators. Yeah. Also, maps with zero charges don't show object also. Yep. So I don't understand why keys with zero charges could open the hatch.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it was dumb, to be honest.
To be honest, it finally makes Friendless Demise useful again, because yeah, that perk is a must against keys. It's like the only perk that counts keys, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Keys are still annoying, and you know, bro, they told that they are getting a rework, but
where
we
is
don't
the
know when it will open.
Where is the rework? I'm still waiting.
Yeah, yeah. Now it's 7 months. They nerfed Morris, but yep. Keys are still there.
Yeah. The rest is just bug fixes and such, but I'm not gonna read them, because let's be honest, all of these things takes too much to read.
Yeah, but don't. I would suggest not to be too happy, because there are still lots of bugs in the game.
Yeah,
and,
behavior.
Okay, yeah, because one could maybe you read. Oh, they fixed all these bugs, so the game is okay now. It's not true.
To be honest, yeah. Behavior motto. We're gonna for every bug that we fix, we're gonna add 20 new ones for its place.
Yeah. Also, remember, the offering for Raccoon City map is still disabled.
Yep, it is.
And now, remember, the chapter released on June the 15th. So it's almost 1 month, and the map still has problems.
Yep. It's, and I think Capcom is not happy about it. I think Capcom is not happy about it if they knew about this, you know. And if they do, to be honest, if Capcom would have contacted them and said, we were expecting you guys to represent our game and such, and there are still bugs that are associated with our license. Fix it. But what do I know? What do I know? It is it's typical behavior. Anyway, these are all the changes that are in the test server, all the important changes. So, and to be honest, they still need to fix a lot of shit, a lot of crap. Don't you think, Vulcan?
Yeah, I agree, and I also think this is the reason why we don't get so many updates in this patch, because they are focusing on fixing bugs.
Or they are focusing too much on cosmetics. Could also be, you know, they could also be focusing on cosmetics. Because I don't... They really need to start doing health pads, you know?
Yeah, yeah, and also don't forget that cosmetics is equal to money for you.
Yeah, that's true. I think we have talked enough. Tricks to good. Tricks to add-ons. Better. Quinton's face. Best. The face of Quinton update. Best change in the entire, in this entire patch. This and this, no, just this. This is the best update in this entire patch.
True.
Quintus face. And the second is this one. So, number one, number two, and then the tricks buffs. That is all I have to say, and I thank you guys for watching. And what do you say, Falcon?
Let's hope that now Trickster will be at least viable now.
Yeah. Anyway, guys, you heard our opinion. I hope that you guys have enjoyed it, because we have enjoyed ourselves making this. And the only thing I have to say is there was Game K and Falcon FX.
See you soon.
And we both say auf Wiedersehen, arrivederci, sayonara, and we hope to see you all next time. KMK and Falcon out. Bye, and stay safe out there.